Hello everybody, my name is Harvey. Today I will show you how to capture syslog on DrayTek routers. So we have four ways to capture syslog on a DrayTek router. First, we can use a DrayTek syslog utility tool. Secondly, we can save syslog to an attached USB disk. Third, we can use syslog explorer in the diagnostic tabs. And fourth, we can use some Telnet commands in certain special circumstances. We will now start with the syslog utility tool. We now have a 2927 and we go to the system maintenance syslog tab. We enable syslog, select the syslog server, and then type in the syslog server IP address. Where do we get this address? We just use the PC connected to the router as the syslog server, and we do an IP config to get the correct IP address. Here it is shown to be 192.168.1.10, which we enter as a server IP address here. We can also put a filter on the syslog capture, such as firewall, VPN, user access, WAN info, DSL, and wireless LAN info. This is to filter out on the info instead of getting a clogged syslog with unnecessary details. Then we go to the DrayTek website to download the syslog utility. We then run the exe file, and here it is ready to capture the syslog. Sometimes you need to check the PC firewall to make sure it is blocking the data capture. And here you can see the syslog being captured. You can now see the firewall, VPN, user access, connection, interface, IPBX, and wireless tabs. And some of them, like the interface tab, has additional tabs such as the WAN, LAN, and DSL debug logs. You can also show the traffic graphs. Now I will show you how to save the current syslog capture to a file. You click on the Save tab and you have a selection of Save to a file or Record log to a file in real time, or even Record log to multiple files. You just give the file a name and click OK. Then you can open the file in the download folder. Here is a saved syslog file. This concludes our first method of capturing a syslog. Now we move on to the second method of saving the syslog to an attached USB disk. You just connect your USB stick to a USB port and then, as usual, check the time and date of the router. And then click on the syslog tab. Enable the syslog. Tick the USB disk. Note here that the USB disk needs to be FAT formatted and be not more than 16 gig. You should also select to overwrite the oldest log. Here we selected 8 gigabyte. And as usual, select which filter you would like to apply, such as firewall, VPN, user access, WAN, DSL, etc. And you can then fetch the saved syslog in the file explorer in the USB application folder. You just click on the log file and it will be saved in the downloads folder. Here is the syslog collected. This concludes the second method of collecting syslog on a USB disk. Our third method of collecting syslog is to use the syslog explorer feature in the diagnostic tab. As usual, we will check the date and time that will reflect in the syslog. Then we go to the syslog explorer tab and enable web syslog. Then select syslog type. This is where the filters are selected one at a time or all of them. And we will select the display mode as always record the new event. You can then export the captured log and display it from the downloads folder. The main disadvantage of using this method is the limited amount of data that can be collected, but it can be useful in certain circumstances. Now, we move on to the fourth method of collecting syslog, which uses Telnet command lines. However, this method is used only under DrayTek head office supervision, as it requires a special firmware that contains a script which will raise a log event in case of error. This log collection may be run for hours and would take a huge amount of data to be collected. Hence, the script will filter out events not related to the issue being monitored. So we now move to the Telnet part of the demo. We open a command prompt, and after having changed the directory to the clocaldata folder, we start the Telnet mode by typing telnet, and then type setlog file capture.txt, which will be the name of the captured syslog text file. And we type open 192.168.1.1 to connect to the router. You will then be prompted for the admin username and password. And finally, we launch the log capture mode by typing sysconTutel enable. From this screen, you can start debug mode by typing Ctrl S, and this will start the log capture, and to exit by pressing the space bar. Here you can see a typical log, and note there is no event shown except for a system memory status. Remember, you need a special modified firmware to do this syslog capture. We can then go to the local data folder and open the capture.txt file, which you can see here. This concludes the demo on the four types of syslog capture available for DrayTek routers. Thank you.